It's been a long year without you, my friend, and I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you again. Nice new goose graffiti.
Awesome.
There is no cyber club.
Fake news.
New team models. No new CT models.
Racism.
No palm tree where palm tree used to be.
Literally unplayable.
Now that I made a lot of funny jokes and grab your attention, so you're gonna like the video and tell me how much of a funny guy I am in the comment section. Let's continue with the actual video. One of the most iconic maps of Counter-Strike got a new look, DE Dust 2. Just recently, Valve announced and added the map to the official beta that everybody can opt into. The beta 1.36.07RC1 features the new DE Dust 2. Welcome to the new DE Dust 2 and why it is not fully satisfying for me. Valve has finally released a major update after a long time. Every casual player knows Dust 2. I mean, the map seems to represent Counter-Strike to everyone who has ever played, watched or heard of the game. The Counter-Strike related video that has the most views is playing on Dust 2. I mean, come on. So what's good about the new map in my eyes? The look in general is very appealing to me. More visibility and a better fit to the theme that is created by its name, DE Dust 2. The textures, all of it, they just play together very well. I don't think there is a big argument needed in that sense. The new visuals of the map look great from my point of view. It seems that it is not only the looks though, but at the same time the performance increased. Whether it is just me or it is actually the case, I'm not really sure about. A few new positions are available. The car spots are better to reach. You can now speed Gonzalez around them as opposed to the old Dust 2 where it was a hit or miss situation as you had to jump into it and out of it. Overall, just a more smooth play around the car spots as well as new angles are given on A long and on B sight. Wallbangs are implemented from CT spawn to A short and from middle doors to lower tunnels. Whether this was intentional or not is a different story, but it is a very welcome change for me if it is added on purpose considering 1.6 it was wallbangable and stuff like that. The higher catacombs slash the tunnels at B and A long allow for new plays in general. It will be interesting to see how this will play out exactly, but yeah, it's a good change. It's a new change, it's an interesting change. However, I feel a lot of potential is wasted on recreating DE Dust 2. The minimal changes to not kill the map's standards is a valid way to go about it. I for myself would have loved to see more drastic changes though. The idea of having more open skyboxes towards B via tunnels T spawn, worth a try. However, the results would have maybe been too heavy for the B player, which is usually playing solo, having too much to deal with, especially against good teams and good players. I still would have loved to try this out and see how it actually plays out and works out. Especially I would have loved to see what pro teams are doing with it, but I guess we will never know. The map overall feels too cubic. What I mean by cubic is that many spots where people could move properly are now merely corners where you're boxed in. Middle doors is an example. The corner on A shortly after catwalk is an example. It just seems to destroy a little bit more of the movement. It benefits the static gameplay, the positioning, which is a point I always loved about CSGO. The fast adjustments that were able to be made, the fast gameplay. Now it seems like you're stuck in that corner. You either get that thing or you're not. I'm not entirely sure if I'm gonna be a fan of that, but definitely not at this point. Many edges are disadvantages. Short corner nades don't always work. See the flashing or the smoking or anything coming from short catwalk towards the stairs. The catwalk area should be a flattened ceiling in my eyes. Instead, the nades can now bounce left and right off towards the middle or towards onto catwalk, making it very, very unpredictable how these things are gonna fly. Middle box only has one way to go up, as well as the wooden plate in front of it not covering the entire box, makes it sometimes unpredictable as well. No crouch jump is needed anymore on the B site, which lowers the movement skill ceiling even more. I'm a fan of the mechanical skills being rewarded for the players. And in this sense, it's just, it makes it more noob friendly. Is that a good or a bad thing? For me personally, it's a bad thing. It's not much that people have to learn to make these crouch jumps happen, but it's still something that I would have loved to see. Some minor edge bugs, for example, running up on B side from middle CT spawn area, jumping on the box from CT spawn to boost someone. Short jump to CT spawn has an edge which prevents you from jumping down properly, but I guess all of these things will be fixed eventually or are even already fixed when I release this video. The cast should be better wall bangable, or maybe add glasses where you can see people a little bit through, shoot them, and then they are an open target. So once the CT is spotted, he doesn't have too much area to move around the car, peek, hide, re-peek, hide, re-peek, hide, before getting flushed out by Molotovs and or grenades. A long as a terrorist has little room to work with now, the plateau area and the backside of pit, the small catwalk, got removed, kind of. So as a CT, you can nearly be sure that the guy will be only in pit. Because what other chance has the terrorist of doing something from long if he took control of it? Which makes it a lot easier for a CT to hold it. And the same goes for a CT op wanting to peek middle. The terrorists will nearly always have the upper hand because they can walk back, only make the head appear, whereas the CT is fully visible all the time. So it seems to me that the map has got a couple of very good changes, but at the same time, these changes are benefiting either the CTs drastically or the Ts drastically. More of a map where, well, certain spots are always the spots of certain players if they play it right. I would welcome all of these spots to be more balanced out, so it's the CTs and the Ts coming down to how they play it, instead of the CTs having the upper hand by default and the Ts having the upper hand by default on certain areas. Some minor adds though, the window retakes on B as a CT are better now due to the wider angles, which is nice. The visibility as well, which is nice. The little wooden thing, plate in front of B's site is now properly walkable, which is a very welcome change for me as well, opening up a couple of aggressive plays. The contesting middle as a terrorist is something where you can get creative now with a direct half box jump. I like that as well. I would love to see something for the CTs to go up on the other side as well, however. And the barrels got traded now for haystacks, way, making it not as frustrating to try and shoot a guy from A-long towards upper side. In conclusion, I like the new disc too. I have to get used to the new sounds as always, I just can't describe what it is, but I'm not feeling satisfied with the map overall yet. Maybe I expected more drastic changes, or maybe I'm still looking for something else which I can't describe. However, in my eyes, it is right to say that Valve did a good job on the map. Now I just hope it won't take us another year to welcome another major update. Thank you for watching, everybody. Let me know what you think of this kind of video. Have a good day. See you in the next video. Yeah. Bye.